Now, good news for our inmates. The Uganda Prison Services has submitted the names of 682 people. These are inmates for the presidential pardon. Now, while addressing journalists today, prison spokesperson Frank Baine said the move is aimed at decongesting prisons around the country which have been affected by COVID-19 because congestion leads to more spread of the virus. We have this report. The Constitution of Uganda gives powers to the President to pardon various categories of prisoners on advice of the prerogative of Mercy Committee and the Attorney General. Every year, Uganda Prison submits names of inmates deemed fit for pardon.
In July of the year, we submit those names which we deem fit for pardon. And it is the discretion of the prerogative of Mercy Committee to look through and forward to the president for pardon, or sit on the lists, and then the year passes without the pardon. But for us, it is a religious submission of every July, and that's what we have done.
This July, a list of 682 names of prisoners have been submitted. The list includes all petty offenders who have finished three quarters of their sentences, all offenders convicted of capital offenses but are left with only 6 months to finish their punishments, all convicts above 64 years, among others.
We have submitted 682 names for a possibility of pardon. And the categories of these people are as follows. All petty offenders that have finished three quarters of their sentence they are part of this group. All convicted capital offenders that are remaining with 6 months to go home, they are part of this group. All overage convicted offenders that have finished half of their sentence, when you talk of overage, that is 65 and above, they are part of this category. When we talk of convicts of rape and robbery, and even those who have just started the sentence, as long as the...
Last year, President Yoweri Museveni pardoned a total of 833 prisoners across the country in a move that was aimed at decongesting prisons across the country during the COVID pandemic. Meanwhile, Uganda Police Force has opened an inquiry into the alleged threat on the life of Prime Minister Robin Nabbanja.
And we're aware that they were basically directed through the second party, who is a brother. Allegedly, we've tried to get a statement from him and try to build on that. So we shall find out to the level of the threats as we progress along. But we've always, in Kakumiro, we've not had any big threats regarding our home and even our businesses. There were some two hotels where there's a matter which we handled amicably. So even this one, the RPC is and his regional team are following it up. If there are good leads that are provided by our brother, then we shall be able to build on that. But we already have the general inquiry file.
The police are also investigating a series of organized robberies involving motorcyclists. The recent was an attack captured on CCTV camera of Boda Boda cyclists robbing an Indian national.
This motorcycle gang is also in their operations. They also target persons making withdrawals from ATMs. We are still studying. We've managed to identify a group. But now the group that attacked Township, that is Kamasanya, and we've also gotten very good clear pictures from the group which attacked this Indian businessman. They are still in hiding, but at least we now know who they are. We've identified the motorcycles that they use, which will guide our investigations. Then they also focus on mobile money points and even pedestrians, particularly women, carrying handbags. So we want to always come out and use this opportunity.
On the other hand, Agnes Igoye, the Deputy Coordinator for Prevention of Trafficking in Persons in the Ministry of Internal Affairs, says there's an increase of lease marriages where schoolgirls are married off during the time they are out of school.
Who are being used for hawking and selling things, because that is wrong. Children are, people who are getting cows out of children because you want them to get married at an early age. So that is wrong. So we are intensifying our investigations, and I'm going around the country to do that. So I'm headed to the eastern part of Uganda next, because I know even there reports are coming out because child marrying, they are targeting these children. And we are really going front to that. So that's
report by Rachel Nachiwala.